me and me cousin one, our fair McBride, as we went walking down by the seaside. Now mark what followed and what did betide, for it being on Christmas morning. Out for recreation we went on a tramp, and we met Sergeant Napper and Corporal Vamp, and a little wee drummer intending to camp, for the day being pleasant and charming. Good morning, the sergeant did cry, and the same to you gentlemen we did reply. Intending no harm, but meant to pass by, for it being on Christmas morning. But says he, my fine fellows, if you will enlist, it's 10 guineas in gold I will slip in your fist, and a crown in the bargain for to kick up in the dust, and drink the king's health in the morning. For a soldier, he leads a very fine life, and he always is blessed with a charming young wife, and he pays all his debts without sorrow or strife, and always lives pleasant and charming. And a soldier, he always is decent and clean, in the finest of clothes, and he's constantly seen, while other poor fellows go dirty and mean, and sup on thin gruel in the morning. But says Arthur, I wouldn't be proud of your clothes, for you've only the length of them, as I suppose. And you dare not change them one night, for you know if you do, you'll be flogged in the morning. And although that we are single and free, we take great delight in our own company, and we have no desire strange faces to see, although that your offers are charming. And we have no desire to take your advance, all hazards and dangers we barter on chance, for you would have no scruples for to send us to France, where we would get shot without warning. Oh, now, says the sergeant, I'll have no such chat, and I neither will take it from spalpeen or brat. For if you insult me with one other word, I'll cut off your heads in the morning. And then Arthur and I, we soon drew our hats, and we scarce gave them time for to draw their own blades, when a trusty shillelagh came over their heads and bade them take matters for warning. And their own rusty rapiers that hung by their side, we flung them as far as we could in the tide. Now take them out, devils, cried Arthur McBride, and temper their edge in the morning. And the little wee drummer, we flattened his pout, and we made a football of his rowdy-dow-dow, threw it in the tide for to rock and to roll, and bade it a tedious returning. And we haven't no money, paid them off in cracks, and we paid no respect to their two bloody backs, for we lathered them there like a bear of wet sacks, and left them for dead. morning. And so, to conclude and to finish disputes, we obligingly asked if they wanted recruits. For we were the lads who would give them hard clouts and bid them look sharp in the morning.